go out of 2013 into 2014. Lord, revive us. Because truly we don't want to take what we had in 13. We want to drop it. We want to leave it. And we want to press on to 14. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Giving honor to God.
Amen.
Who is the head of my life.
Woo! Oh, yes.
Exceeding hot, the flame of the fire slew these men, and took up Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, and these three men. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego fell down, bound into the midst of the burning fiery furnace. Then Nebuchadnezzar, the king, was astounded, and rose up in haste and spake, and said unto his counselors, did not we cast three men bound into the midst of the fire? They answered and said unto the king, true, O king. He answered and said, lo, I see four men loose walking in the midst of the fire, and they have no hurt. And the form of the fourth is like the Son of God.
Come on.
Then Nebuchadnezzar came near to the mouth of the burning fire furnace, and spake and said, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, ye servants of the Most High God, come forth and come hither. Then Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego came forth of the midst of the fire, and the princes, governors, captains, and the king's counselors, being gathered together, saw these men upon whose bodies the fire had no power. No power.
No power.
Nor was a hair of their head singed. Neither were their coats changed. Nor the smell of the fire had passed on them. Then Nebuchadnezzar spake and said, blessed be the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who hath sent his angels and delivered his servants that trusted in him, and have changed the king's word, and yielded their bodies, that they might not serve nor worship any god except their own God. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Oh, Heavenly Father, I come to you as humble as I know in power, God. I'm coming asking you, oh, Heavenly Father, to touch the ears of the people in this place, oh God. Oh God, open up their hearts, mind, and soul, oh God, that they may hear your word, that they will receive it, oh God, that it will become a blessing to them and to their families, oh God. Father God, I pray that you decrease me, God, that you may add the increase in me, oh Father. Use me as your vessel, oh God. You speak through me, Heavenly Father. And, oh, God, we pray, oh, God, that you will give Bishop and Pastor safe passage back to their homes, oh, God. We pray for their families, oh, God. We pray for all the families here, oh, God. Or we pray for Sister Sharon's family, oh, God. Lord, you touch right now. Have your way in everything, oh, God. In Jesus' name, we give you the victory. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
You may have
peace be unto the Most High.
If I had to use a title today, it would be, how much is it worth to you to trust God? Say to your neighbor, ask the question, how much is it worth to you to trust God? Thank you, Jesus. It is worth to me to trust God with everything. Everything that I have. If it comes down to my children, comes down to my home, my vehicle, everything that's valuable to me, it is worth it to me to trust God. Because none of that belongs to me anyway. It all belongs to God. He makes the way for it. He gives us everything that we need. Our children are not ours. They're only loaned to us. Amen. God let us loan them. Yes. He puts them and trusts them in our hands for us to raise them up and bring them up in his image. Amen. So everything that we have, it belongs to him. Amen. So I want to tell you that I'm going to try to trust God with everything that I have. It's worth it to me to give him all, because I truly want him to be the glory of my life. Yes. We have three kinds of people who would trust God. One of them would be some of the time people. Then we got none of the time people. But I want to be in the all of the time. The some of the time people are those those that call on him and trust him until he answers them.
All right.
Then they forget about him until they have another need. The none of the time people are those that trust and believe in their own strength. Yes. Those are the ones that they don't believe nothing. They believe that they do everything on their own. Hmm. They believe that they wake their own self up. They don't believe that it's through God's grace and mercy that he give us the strength to see another day.
Oh yes.
All of the time people are those that trust in him in every situation. Whether it be good or whether it be bad. Job said, though he slay me, yet will I trust in him. But I will maintain my own way before him.
Yes.
Psalm 62:8 says, trust in him at all times, ye people. Pour out your heart before him. Yes. God is a refuge for us.
Mm-hmm.
And I looked up the word refuge. Refuge, one of the meanings was a shelter against harm. God is our shelter. We can go into him and he will protect us from all harm.
Amen.
I don't know about you, but I got to trust him like I never trusted him before.
Oh, yeah.
Because there is a time coming, church, with your walk with God, that you may encounter a fiery furnace or some lions in your den like Daniel. Or a plot planted through you in the pit like Joseph.
Yes.
How much is it worth to you to trust God? The Hebrew boys told King Nebuchadnezzar, the God we serve is able to deliver us from the burning fire furnace.
Amen.
And he will deliver us from out of your hands, O King. But if not, be it known, O King, we will not serve your gods or worship your golden image. I don't care what the enemy may try to bring up in your past. That's all it is, just the past. 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. The Bible says King Nebuchadnezzar got so angry that he commanded the furnace to be heated 7 times hotter than normal. He commanded his most mighty men to bind the Hebrew boys with their coats, hats, socks, and all other garments, the Bible says, that they had on. Now, when the mighty men went to put them in, it says the flame, the fire, slew, or killed, if you want to say, the mighty men. But the Hebrew boys fell down, bound in the midst of the fire, praying and worshiping God, because they will only serve the true and living God. I can just imagine the old Hebrew boys when they got in there. They fell down and they began to say, praising God. Oh God, we thank you. Oh God, we love you. Oh God, I trust you. Oh God, you're a deliverer. Oh God, I know you're almighty. Oh God, you're the creator of all. Oh God, you're the God of more than enough. Oh God, you're Jehovah Jireh, the Lord is my provider. Oh God, you're Jehovah Shalom, the Lord is my peace. The God is of Jehovah. Men into the midst of the fire.